Okay, it's June 21st, 2016, the longest day of the year. I've probably got about 100 videos that I've got on my computer right now that I'm just going to get rid of because I've been transferring them. Then I put some of them on Facebook. I get no comments, no nothing, so you know, what the hell's the use? Just come out here and show you the peppers are getting bigger. This one's the one that we wintered through the winter. It was full of leaves and everything else we put out here. The winds out here as bad as they have been and are getting again. Seriously, that was completely covered with leaves. Look at it now. And some others out here have planted 3 seeds. Generally, you sow your peppers inside and then put them out here, but I put a seed down there, there, and there. I don't remember that, but I don't know. But they're doing okay. Next time they're gonna go out into the garden, up against the house. And look over here. I realized I planted the corn way too close together. I was just doing to see if they came up, and they all came up. Okay, so 6 foot, 7 foot tall, a bunch of them. I did 12 in the first row. 3 weeks later, I did 12. Then only 2 weeks later, I did 12. And then about 8 days or 7 days or so, I did another 12. And because it's so close, I thought, well, I'm going to get one more row at least. But I only put 5 in there. And as you can see down there, there's one just busting them above the soil right there. They're coming up. All 5 of these are coming up. So the okra is doing okay. All right. Ouch. I planted another seed with this. But see, I hate when these leaves get here because the trees around here, as far as I'm concerned, are infected or they're dying. So anyway, there's another seed down in there. And then this one, for some reason, is dying off. Well, that's a blade of grass. I was going to say I had an okra seed over here, too, but that's the grass. Sometimes I come out here and pull everything up by hand. It's not bad out here. It's windy, a little bit cool, but it's going to get hot. As you can see, the okra being forced out there. The torch sunflower is going right over top of the okra. The okra will wind that out. So I might trim back these torch again. Let's see, that's an okra plant right there. This one here. Yeah, there's corn. I've got some ears of corn too already. Well, not already, but you know. See, right, you can see the silk on it starting. Right there. And I hate these, what some people call flip-flops or thongs. I get stuff underneath my heel when I walk across this because it's got cut grass on here. Mowed grass, whatever you want to call it too. See, there's one right there. No, and I planted this out here because they told me the farmers around here who the fathers, this is Homestead, this is where he grew up when he was younger. He'll be 90 on his birthday this year. Said they were going to put cotton and soybeans around here in 300 acres that surround us. And I didn't like that too much, but you know, anyway. So the cotton is right on top of us. That's about 20 feet on the other side of the garden. With the most potent insecticide poisons they can put on there to protect their crop, their Monsanto cotton. And then, oh wait, they didn't put soybean down. They put fucking corn down up there on the hills. And this will cross-pollinate. Jesus Christ. So anyway, I'm gonna get off of that right now. So, we've had some zucchinis already. Mostly yellow. Had those squash bugs. But see, this is supposed to be a golden zucchini yellow. See the yellow a little bit on the back of it? It's green, but see there's yellow down there too on that one. We pulled a couple green off of here. My wife did. This is the green Black Beauty, of which we got some seeds off of it. We didn't let them sit for 2 weeks or anything. We got them in the house, still drying out, but we went ahead and planted 3 of them. And they're not coming up yet. Of course not, because it's too soon. I don't think they will. Right here was one of the holes, and right there was a hole where we put them in. Nothing's coming up, and the other one was back over here. Where is it? Right there. There's nothing coming up there, of course. Right there, right there. So you should let, whenever you get your seeds, let them dry out for about 2 weeks. Then you can replant them. Unless, of course, you're from Monsanto, which, you know, they want to control the food of the world. Kind of wonder why, huh? People that created napalm and DDT and all the poisons that kill people and kill insects, and they're controlling your food. Your food. I'd really, really go out of my way to not eat anything out of the stores. Cucumbers are looking somewhat. This one here, armadillo was out here a couple days ago. That's the only thing I can think of because it's knocked over like it was stepped on. Had a big corn stalk that was knocked over too. You know, so I got no trespassing signs all over the place here on private property. And well, we're in the country and I have a natural right under common law to protect myself and my living area. My custodial property. Watermelon, watermelon, watermelon. Honeydew or cantaloupe? I get much bigger yet. Let's pull out any growing. There's a watermelon growing here. And then there's this one here. This one's really taking off. Look at that. This one here is going to have melons all over this one. I guarantee you that. It's the 21st of June, the warmest day, as I said. Probably about another month. I mean, we've seen some, I don't know if you're going to call them pods or whatever, you know, pods where people go to sleep and wake up. They're not them, though. But, you know, I'm fine focusing on them. Where's that now? Hey, buddy. I really wish you wouldn't do that. I can't see on this viewfinder with the sun, but anyway, there's a couple. They look like little green pod type thing. This one doesn't have any yet, just flowers. This one's got about 3 or 4 or 5 or 6 or 7 or 8 or 9 maybe. Anyway, mammoth sunflower, that's at least 10 feet tall right now. It's over, towers over my head. Okra. Oh, okra over here's got a flower on it. It's so small. Maybe it's a new version. Maybe it's the miniature okra. It's got a flower on it, pollinated. And that's only about 10 inches out of the ground. That one's got a flower on it, too. That one there doesn't have a flower, and it's a little bit bigger than this one. Okay, the beans over here, the ones that should have been planted in February, not middle of April. Spy plane up there somewhere. You know what I like to do? See this right here? I like to give them this up in the air all the time because, you know, they're looking at us and taking pictures and whatnot. I just hold it up over my head while I'm videoing out here. Petey, come on, buddy. Come on, boy. Thank you. Now, buddy, come on. Okay, waiting for my beans here. See, here I got a few on this one. See, this fencing, I should take this fencing up. I wasn't sure if this would be a bush or a vine. It looks like a bush, so I'm going to try to carefully pull that up all of that plant right there. This is like a vine here, the first one. That's a bush, so I'm going to take this away too. Not right now with this camera in my hand, but this is what I call a lead. It's about 24 inches apart. That was the start of a bunch of these over here before. Like that first one, this first one here. And then have it go on, but again, mixed results because they should have been planted in February. And then about the fourth week of March, they would be starting to grow. And then April and May, and then they would have been about done. But, you know, this heat is not doing good. It's stressing them out. And you see the dryness on the leaves, the yellowish. So, again, this is one of those things. I'm learning as I do it. Every year, I have a little bit something different, a little bit something different. So, next year again, we're going to cut this one here in the back. So it'll be like this here where you have a walkway in between it. It may be not as short as these two, but probably cut it right on this side here in between that row and that row and that row and go right up. And over here, And between those two right there going back. So we'll have four gardens. One will be that one closest to the house. Two will be the next one right here. My balance. Two. And then three will be on the back left. And four will be the back right, facing north. See, now this is, these are Mexican beans. I can't think of, I should remember the name, and I don't remember it now. But they're like a tan bean. It's a Mexican bean. It was in a bag that we bought at Aldi's, which has a decent organic selection of vegetables and such. So I didn't know if they would grow. I put them out here, and voila, we got our own Mexican beans. Yeah, the tomatoes, the biggest tomato plant, you can see two of them are starting to turn a little bit, getting a little orangish color to them. And see them from the house, that's when I knew it, and I come out here. I still like that one down the bottom. I don't know if it shows up good. I saw a little bit over by the front porch. So that would be a good one for green tomatoes, if anybody likes green tomatoes. I'm telling you, where's my finger at? Right here, right down there. It's a big one. That's about the size, almost the size of a 12-inch softball. And then this one only has two on it, but it had a couple flowers, I thought. Need to get some fertilizer over here. Put it on top of the soil down there. So we've got to watch for the worms. Once you see one, we see like this here now. I don't know if you can see this on the video. You see that leaf right here? Let me pinch it off. See, that's the thing is, you need to pinch off when you see leaves like this. You see the brown, the spots on it? See, now I can't touch another plant with my hands because it'll cross-contaminate them. See, there's another one right here. Pinch that off. Actually, all this hole is right here, it looks like. I should use shears or my knife there. I got all the ones that had a little bit of brown spot. This one here's got some flowers on it. Right down there, you can see those two flowers. I'm watching for worms on here. These leaves, and I'm trying to take white one. Epsom salt and sugar. I sprayed on, but it's been a while, so I'm gonna have to do it this evening. It's supposed to rain, so if it doesn't rain this evening, tomorrow morning, bright and early, and come out here and water down some Epsom salt and sugar on all these tomato plants. Yeah. Well, this is out of four peanut plants. For some reason, I just have this one above ground here. Dug a hole down about 4 inches, 5 inches or so. And put four peanuts down there, right down there, and over there, and over here. But only this one seems to be sprouting out for peanuts. This is a pumpkin plant, how it's overtaken here. Oh, man, look at that. Next year, one pumpkin plant. This got to be put away from the garden. Look at how it goes out. That's about 25 feet. Huh? That's what I said. Just one next year. But away from the garden, you know. I can put it like... yeah, that's just what I was going to say. Right about where the swing is or something. And let it grow on out. Look at that. That's about 25 feet. Well, the sunflowers, a lot of them are opening up, the faces of them. With flower heads. Traditional sunflower, I should say. Yellow. The yellow, brown, or black, whatever you're going to call it. Thank you. Can't see on the viewfinder, but I know right there it is. And here, oh. That's about almost 5 foot. That's about 4'10". That's 5 foot, that plant right there. About 6 foot almost, actually. So this one getting ready to open up. Let me get over here. Well, that's a possibility. Tomorrow that one will be open, or later this evening maybe even. See, different types. I got four different types of sunflowers out here. That one right there. Then this one right here. See the bees, honeybees on it? That's the thing, an important reason for that. Petey, come on, buddy, off the plastic, please. This one here, and then you get the tall. That right there. And then you see that one back there. That's the one that's like 11, 12 feet tall. That's a mammoth sunflower. That's the one I wanted to have a bunch of those. I wanted to have like about 12 of those around the garden. Pardon? Well, with the heat out here, and like it's going to be in the low 90s the rest of the week anyway. If it doesn't rain tonight, that's why I said the tomatoes tomorrow get Epsom salt and sugar. Yeah. These are some of the medicinal flowers I got from Heirloom Solutions. I have out here. I just threw a variety of stuff down there. These here were in a flower pot. We transferred them over here about 2 weeks ago. Looking like they were thirsty, so but they're alive and they're okay. These are seeds from Heirloom Solutions too. That was from either Kmart or China Mart, and that does look like a. It can't be a weed for it to be so evenly like this. When I say it must be something we planted, they gotta be. They look like mint. Because they're right in a row here. Oh yeah, there's mint. I showed you the mint. Oh, mint lettuce. Okay. Well, anyway, I mean, for it to be exact like it is, that had to have been planted there. As I was trying to put medicinal flowers all around the garden, that's a torch sunflower right there, that bush, like, and that big one there with the orange flowers. Lucy, you're on the video. This is a torch sunflower right here. Don't know if I want to leave that there with the corn, though. But yeah, we got Monsanto corn. God. Anyway. Stop. My garlic here. This will help from radiation, too, by the way. Garlic. Especially my garlic. Yeah. Alright. So. Oh, look at the bees. I want to show you the bees with our hummingbird feeders. My wife put out a bowl of sugar water. And it's attracting them away from the bird, the hummingbird feeders at least. I'm not getting it too close. I'm getting them excited. That way they stay away from the hummingbird feeders. There might be a few stragglers over there, but anyway. That's it for now.